afternoon. Welcome to Holy Trinity to our Lenten Noontime Concert Series. Thank you for watching from wherever you are. Remember, the arts are very important to us here at Holy Trinity, and we like to provide good, life-affirming art to you, the community, and offer a safe place for artists of all kinds to come and play. So thank you for being part of this. I always tell people, I believe there's two kinds of art. There's art about the light, and then there's art that depicts what the light reveals about the world, and that's what you're going to be experiencing today. So it's my pleasure, we're going to be featuring unaccompanied music for cello and gamba today. One of the preeminent musicians in all of Western Canada, Josephine van Lier, will be playing the Baroque cello and the viola da gamba. So please sit back and enjoy this 50 minutes of wonderful music. And without further ado, I introduce Josephine van Lier. Thank you.
Thank you. It is a pleasure to be here and a little strange to know that you are all out there and not in here with me. I'm going to play half the program on viola da gamba, the other half on my Baroque cello. And the gamba portion I'm going to divide into two sets, so hold your applause until the first, after the first set. I'm going to play first a piece by Diego Ortiz. And Ortiz was a Spanish composer born in 1510, especially well known for his book, the Tratado de Glosas, which was the first manual on ornamentation for bowed string instruments. And these retrocadas, there a whole series of them, are actually written for a bowed bass instrument. I'm going to play the second one in this first set. I will then continue with a piece by John Playford. We're jumping ahead in time, born in 1623 in London. And he was a bookseller, a publisher, and a composer, minor composer. In that capacity, he was best known for his English Dancing Master, of which I'll play Lull Me Beyond Thee. And then we go to Telemann, a different era yet again, born in 1681. And I'm going to play his seventh fantasia for viola da gamba solo. It's in G minor. Now, these fantasias were written in 1735, and we have always known they had been published because he himself self-published them. He had a subscription series for all of his published works, and we know it was on there. We know it was sent out to the subscribers, but it's never been found since, until 2016. And so it's a very recent discovery, so I'm super excited to work on these fantasias. And as you understand, there are still very few people in the world playing them or hearing them, so for you this will be a bit of a treat as well. He wrote these at a time that the viola da gamba was no longer very fashionable. The violin family had really won the battle between the types of instruments, and so he had a very critical audience to write these for. He had to make sure that the buyers were challenged both intellectually and technically. So I will start with Ortiz.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. I will continue with another set much like that. Second Richecar by Diego Ortiz, followed by Parson's Farewell by Playford, and then the Fantasia number 3 in E minor by Telemann. And some of you are here from Alberta and know how incredibly dry it is in this province. And being on gut strings, they shrink a lot when it is this dry, so they keep getting out of tune. So I'll take some time tuning. Here, because once people start breathing, the humidity changes significantly and makes them even more out of tune. Keep breathing out there.
Thank you.
For those of you who don't know about that. I'm going to play the fifth cello suite by Johann Sebastian Bach, and it was written for the cello retuned. Normally we have an A string on the top, and now we have got a G string, so we've tuned the full tone down. So if things aren't complicated enough for me, I just played a viola da gamba with seven strings, tuned like the lutes are in fourths and a third somewhere in the middle, with frets and with a bow that you hold upside down underhand. Now I'm going to a cello without frets, only four strings, tuned in fifths, bow held overhand, and my normally A string is now tuned down a full tone. This suite is absolutely remarkably beautiful. By tuning it down, the cello gets a very deep and dark resonance. So hope you enjoy it. Suite has a prelude, allemande, courante, sarabande, gavotte, and gigue.
Thank you. Thank you.